everyone, welcome to this new video, a very first one with this suit. Hi, I'm the Moon. How are you? Well, today's a very excited video because today we're gonna hear from me and my friends stories about their fursuit experience. Funny story, crazy story, weird stories, a lot of stories. And of course I will tell my own story at the end of the video. So please watch the full video. And I want to thank all the people who joined in this video. So yeah, let's go!
Hey, Fluffy Ferret, Tabo here. First of all, thank you very much for asking me to join with your video. It's much appreciated. One of the more fun things that I experienced, well, actually weird things, during my fursuit outings is that at one point we were fursuiting with a couple of guys and girls, of course, at a theme park. And suddenly a military unit of, the military police, German military police, they drove past us and they screeched and they were all getting out and we were like, oh no, oh dear, what's going on? What's this? What? Turns out they wanted to have a couple of selfies and a group photo. Unfortunately, I cannot share the group photo here because, well, they're military personnel and they need to be anonymous for their job. But that was a really fun experience. Also, one of the most memorable fursuit outings I had was in Paris, mere weeks after those terrible attacks at the theater. And the place was packed with military. Of course, the entire state was in a state of emergency. And even though with all the tensions, we had so much fun. The people that were there, they needed to have a little bit of a break. And even though that it was technically, state of emergency, everybody was enjoying themselves. And even a couple of the military people that were walking around, they were quite nice to us as well. And I believe that a couple of selfies were taken as well. One of those moments that you just feel that, yeah, we're spreading positivity and joy. We are able to actually make an impact, especially for the people that need it most. Yes, I would like to wish you the best of luck. Have a wonderful new year. Cheers, bye bye.
You should edit this out and put him a fall on. Hang on. Hello everyone, my name is Ombiot and my friend Fluffy Ferret Creations asked me to tell some stories about fursuiting I had experienced. So here we go. I haven't been fursuiting for a while, like only 7 months altogether, but it's pretty fun and I've had some experiences, both good and bad. And well, I'm ready to tell some. So the first experience I had was back in April, and I was going to a cosplay meeting, and there was this guy, and so it was a really, really hot day, and I have an all black suit, so I was dying in there, and this guy comes up to me, and he's very drunk, and, well, it's actually a really funny story, but he comes up to me, and he asks, can I have a picture? So I say, yes, and he's like, oh, so you're a girl, that's even better, can I have your number? And I was like, no, because my boyfriend was sitting right next to me. I was like, no, you can't have my number. He was like, oh, that's sad, and then he took a picture, but he was really awkwardly putting his hand around me, and I was like, oh god, no. And, well, luckily, he didn't cause any trouble ever, because he just walked away. But, still really awkward to, like, have that happen to me. That was an awkward experience, so one really, not exactly good, but also not exactly bad is, I was walking in my fursuit. It was actually the same day, and we were walking to the cosplay meeting, and it was still really hot, because it was around 12, so the sun was at its hottest, and there was this kid coming up to me, and I was like, oh, he wants a high five. No, he didn't want a high five, he just tackle hugged me. I could the vision in my suit is not that good, so he tackle hugged me and I didn't expect it, so I almost fall over. It's a good thing I could stand straight and just compose myself, but I could have fallen over because that kid well, could have knocked me over because I'm blind in the suit. But this is another one. And well, a really bad experience because I'm a hellhound, and you can see from my horns, I'm not a like lovely kind like suit. I'm not made for kids, babies, and such. So I was at a fantasy fair in July, and I was just walking, and all of a sudden I heard kids screaming, and I was like, "What the fuck?" So I looked to my side, and they're just kids running away because they see me. They see me and they run away, and I'm like, why do you run away? I may be scary, but I'm not gonna bite you, even if I have love teeth. It's just very upsetting. The kids do that. I'm like, I'm not that scary, right? I can be nice. So yeah, that's some of my stories. I hope you like them.
When I was with a friend and we were both like 14, we went to the playgrounds near my house. A lot of children were there. Dropped by their parents who were just doing their own business in the house, and the kids just go play until it's dinner time or something. We weren't very aware of that, so we just wanted to get in the playground, have some fun, go to the other playground and then go home. But the children, they followed us everywhere. I've had some fursuiting experience where you just go, hi, hugs, photo. And you just go along, they go along, and then there's the next kid, and that's how normally fursuiting works. They thought it was going to be the same way, but it really wasn't. Kids followed us everywhere, to the other playgrounds, and at some point, one kid on rollerblades was like, she grabbed me by the arm, and she said, no! I am not allowed to go that far. And I was like, I don't care. I didn't say that, of course. Those kids were starting to get really annoying. Including having a child know all your tricks already. You've done everything you can. They start pestering you. Start tugging your tail, itching in your mouth, trying to find something human. Touching my legs and find the little area where you can see the skin. And they were like, you are not a real animal. Apparently I was breathing a little louder or something. I have no idea what kind of sound I made, but it wasn't talking. Kids was like, you are talking, you're not an animal. I was this close to being like, fuck you, I wasn't talking, shit child. But yeah, you can't really say that. We didn't want to talk in suit. We didn't want to reveal anything. Those kids know we're not animals, but we just didn't want to take our heads off or say no child. I don't know, we were just very dedicated fursuiters because 10 years ago, that was the thing. I think I still wouldn't really take my hat off. Maybe been better. Well, the actual better thing would be if we had someone with us that was just taking care of us, taking pictures and say like, hey, girls, guys, the animals are very tired. You should just leave them be. We didn't have that. So they were following us. At some point, we were like pointing at each other and shit, we should go home. So we did. Like 20 children were following us to my home. And I wanted to go to the back door of the garden, but I thought maybe that wasn't the best idea because those kids would follow us in my garden and my family wouldn't really appreciate it. So we went to the front door, I rang the bell, and my mother looked at me and looked at all those children. She looked at me back like, the hell, daughter? Hi mom, I brought some kids. I didn't say that. My mom could tell them off. And one child was like, can I use the bathroom? No, you should go home. And I was like, thank you, mother. We finally had our rest after hours of being with the same 20 whatever children. It was awful, actually. But it makes for a good story. And later that day, apparently they were standing in front of the windows after dinner. But we were upstairs, so we didn't really know. And my mother was like, honey, there are children at the window.
So hi, my name is Jenna, and this is my most embarrassing fursuit story. And it all started when I got one of my first fursuit hats, and it was this beautiful falcon hat. But it was realistic, and you know, realistic hats tend to be a little bit more intense than, you know, a 2D hat like this. And so, once I was home with my mom alone, and I went downstairs because I wanted to show my mom this head, and I wanted to show how nice it looked and that its beak could actually move because it was a resin head. And when I did that, I was standing there, you know, being that normal person with a bird head. And I hear the door open behind me. And I was like, you know, it's supposed to be me and my mom home alone. So, who dis? So I turn around and it's the neighbor. Our very normal, down-to-earth neighbor. With eggs, like he did every Sunday. Still does, by the way. And there I am, looking at this man, completely serious, with a falcon head. Yeah, trust me, it took a while for me to explain to him what the hell was going on. And, you know, every time he brings me eggs, he still makes bird jokes. And I don't like it. So yeah, that's my most embarrassing person story, and I really, 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 really hope the neighbor is going to forget soon. But I don't think so.
So my story, I have a quite few funny stories, but I'm gonna only tell like one or two. My first one is not in this zoo, in another zoo. We were taking a group picture with all the furries, and the group picture was over, and I was in my full suit. Yeah, I was in my full suit, this full suit. And I walked away a little on the early side, and I can't see underneath me. I can only see like above me and not underneath me, like normal suits. And something happened. So I was just walking and I bumped into something on the ground, and it was this cute bean on the ground. Doing the dog thing, and I didn't notice, so I walked just normal, and I will draw this happened. I was walking and I made like a salto or a spin. I was like rolling on his legs. He was very soft, so it didn't hurt. I was like, oh my god, I'm so sorry. I want to thank you all for watching. Thank you again for participating.